of you as companions. So Prophet Muhammad was dreaming to see you. When we talk about Gaza, we talk about suffering, we talk about injustice, we talk about negligence, we talk about diseases, we talk about everything. But are we going to lose hope? No way. No way. At the most difficult time that Prophet Muhammad was facing in the battlefield, he was looking forward, seeing all the great palaces of the future of the conquest of Islam, which happened. So the time of darkness now, suffering and hardship, we see the light of hope coming to save us here in this room. Because we need the Gazan to save us. We need the Rohingya people to save us. We need the Iraqi to save us, the Syrian to save us, the Sudanese, the Somali to save us. To stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and say, yes, they have done it. Allah, protect them, shield them, save them, and put them in Firdaus al-A'la. The one who is in need tonight is us. The needy people are us. And the poor people to Allah are us. It's a test on us at the last few days of Ramadan after Allah has given us all these great opportunities. Opportunity after opportunity after opportunity in this blessed month of Ramadan. This dream started 31 years ago. With no vision, no money, no strategy, no office, no structure, nothing. Nothing. When you nurture your dream, when you let the best donors, you know who was the best donors who gave money to Islamic League? Are the people in the first line in the mosque, your fathers, your grandfathers. You used to give me a penny, half a penny, 5 pence, 10 pence, 20 pence, 50 pence, and a pound. This was the best days. The best days that we have from